Let's now take a look at how to export citations from PrimoSearch. We'd really only recommend that you export from Primo when the resource is a physical book. When it comes to journal articles and other electronic resources, you'd be best to export the citations directly from the databases themselves, because they will often contain more comprehensive records. So I'm just going to select the title to open the details of this book. So still in Primo, just looking at the detailed view of this item. And what I need to do is select this EndNote RIS button. Okay, that expands this download option. I don't need to change this encoding dropdown. I just need to select the download button. Now the reference will go into your downloads, and if I just select my browser downloads here, there it is. So depending on your browser, this may be in a different part of your screen. So I'm using Firefox, so that's why it's in my downloads to the right of my URL bar. People using Chrome, you will likely see it pop up in the bottom left of your screen. Now opening the downloaded file should open EndNote, but you may get a window asking you to select which program you want to open the file with. If you get that prompt, just go through the options and select EndNote. Okay, so with the reference selected, we're getting some brief information in the summary here. And if I expand up that preview, we can see my reference preview. Now there's a couple of errors with this. So again, we always want to check the preview to make sure there aren't any errors. Now the problem with this is there shouldn't be this space after chocolate and before the punctuation, and the A following the punctuation should be capitalized as per sentence case. So I'm just going to go into the Edit tab, remove the space after chocolate and replace the A with a capital A. If we scroll through this edit pane, we can see there are more details that have come in with this Primo record, including this ISBN number, some keywords, and some notes. So more details came in with an exported citation than what we added manually. And if I save this, we go back to the summary, my updates or my changes have been updated. But we're still only seeing the information required to create that reference or that reference list entry, even though there's more details within the record in EndNote on that edit panel, it will still only display the required fields.